6th of June, 1816. I must confess that I have not written often of late, and when I do, it is a clemency I give myself, for the inkwell continues to freeze. This has surely been as cold weather as any man has known. The calendar is false. I say, is this not summer? The east hills that overlook my property, they have all been killed by frost. The less fit plants and vegetation beg for mercy where there is none. I have none. I want none. Worse still, an almost perpetual rain confines me principally to pace the house, where I have taken to wearing socks and coats and gloves too big for my fingers. A steady fire has been required at all hours, though the ice in the wood has made it difficult to chop and heavy to carry, troublesome to drag. Copious showers have been attended with lightning and thunder, and the road has been barren of souls for weeks, save for post delivery last Tuesday. Is this what we fought for? I would have welcomed the company, of course, but it was a parcel for Silas. The rider asked to come inside to be spared from the crippling frost, but I set him off. This matter was settled when that damn treaty was signed. I don't understand why I'm being punished. I hope the animals take him. 11th of June, 1816. There has never been so poor a harvest as this season, as now. New England has become a festering graveyard. It was better when the king ruled us, not this uneven wind. Beans are froze, cucumbers, roots, they are froze. The well is froze, the body is froze. Outside, less determined, disgraceful men and wives and daughters stampede like slow, dying bulls, mewling, heading west. Aren't we so full of Christian grace? A persistent fog has reddened and dimmed the daylight. It is as if the sun itself has become pocked and blackened with sores. I'm so very tired. General Jacobs came to the house again, third time in a day. I don't understand his ignorance. I should lie in bed and ignore the knocking. I should make him hope. That will suit him. Hope is for the weak. 13th of June, 1816. As I write this, I'm convinced that the sun has taken ill to defy me, more convinced than I've ever been of anything. Nature is wrought. Or are my superior wits deceived by a fiction gnawing in my belly? Father would say so. Now I've taken to eating loathsome foods, boiled grass and udders, if I can find them. Men came from town yesterday. Where is your brother? Where is your brother Silas? I gave them nothing. We stood on the porch for an hour's time, a senseless eternity. Across the field, a sickly creature limped about. I so wish to reach for my rifle, make quick work and eat again. 18th of June, 1816. Today, Reverend Brown came. I wish to kill him to establish peace. His blood would be my own treaty. A dead bird was frozen in his hand. I bet it was God's judgment. I too have a rifle. No, Reverend, I will not beg nor be humbled before a God who would make of me an American, yet hate me so freely for it. Is he not a father who does not love his kin? Don't we all have our packs to make? Soak them in blood and honor them. I will not be punished by men. 20th of June, 1816. So, I fear this is summer. Lands are all but abandoned, gone like the red sticks, save for me. What beautiful promise this is, Silas. Silas, Silas, Silas. I will not be punished, Silas. Father, you want your son? Take my hands then, for I will not wash his blood from him. This land is mine, should have always been. And if summer survives and I can find a mentor of warmth, I will not bury his body, not my brother. I will let the animals gnaw at his bones, and I will send him to hell in your heaven, Father. May you both be blessed in blood. You want punishment? You found it. I wish you death, your only daughter.